Oh, plenty of oil in the engine. See you later. Bye. Well, that's it. I'm back out on my Himalayan. This time, meeting up with the crew. We're doing a little bit of green laning. I think we're going along the ridgeway. It's only open for a few more days, and then they're shutting it to motor vehicle traffic over winter. Weather conditions, we've had a lot of rain in the last well, couple of weeks really, on and off, a lot of rain, so the tracks could be a bit slippery, and the tyres on my Himalayan, on the back especially, are quite worn. Still legal, but certainly past their best. So let's just hope. Let's hope for the best. There could be some falling off. Let's hope not. Right, I'll front tyre is still good. That's the important thing. And the front tyre is the most important tyre when you're doing a bit of off-roading. Anyway, let's get over to the meeting point, meet up with the others, and then I'll bring you back when we're on the green lane. I think the delivery guy in front there just turned off. He's riding a Honda PCX. Yeah, the reason why I mention that will become apparent in a minute. There they are. Hello, gentlemen.
Morning.
Morning. I just turned in here, and this scooter was in front of me, and it turned into the McDonald's with a big box on the back, and it was a Honda PCX. And I mentioned to Charlie the other day, when I saw her the other day, I said, Dickie's gone and bought himself a 125 Honda PCX. And she said, oh, bless. Well, we all smile for the camera. Colin does this every time before a ride out. We've all got to stand by our bikes. He gets the group photo. Yeah. Come on, get on with it. So we're on a quiet little back road now, just leaving Swindon. Just got to get over these lights, and then we're into a place known as Hodson Woods and Hodson Hamlet, or the little tiny village of Hodson. Colin thought we'd go this way because it would make a nice scenic detour before we hit the ridgeway itself. But actually, we are on our way to a little cafe before we hit the ridgeway, so for a breakfast. Listen to that old bike popping and banging. In a minute we go down into a dip, and there's a beautiful little some beautiful little thatched cottages, the keeper's cottages down there. This is the dip, quite a steep descent as you can see. Colin's pipe bike popping and banging on overrun, and then down here on the left, you'll see the little cottages in a second. Hopefully. I gotta concentrate, but they're down there. Beautiful. And then here's the hamlet of Hodson. Just a small little village, hardly a village, but it has got a pub. Coming on to the Ridgeway. We're on the lower Ridgeway now. The weather's took a turn for the worse, unfortunately. It really is very murky. Blustery winds, it's been raining. The track's wet, traction's gonna be very low. I'm not full of optimism, let's say that. Just gonna take it steady. Along here there are some very, very steep, there are some very deep puddles as well. Thank you. Colin's doing his best to get his bike dirty, I think. Stay out of that. God, flipping heck, it's filthy. Absolutely filthy. Muddy. Oh shit, that's the problem, it's so slippery. That is terrible. Are you alright? Ah. I don't know how deep it is. I don't think it's too bad, Colin.
Trouble.
I think.
No, I'll do that.
Colin, just rest. You've hurt yourself. Look, we'll do it.
Right, well, I'm going to grab this and bring it this way, yeah?
I'll pull the front end then.
Okay.
Now, if he slipped like that with these bloody knobblies on. Hold the clutch in, Dickie.
Right, I got it,
Tony. You sure? Yeah. He's pulled a muscle, has he?
Is it his chest?
I wanted to stop going in there, so I thought I'm going to go in there instead.
Yeah.
In doing that, it slid up there, and then I went down.
Colin! But at least I didn't go in there.
Well, there's still time. You can see where it sort of started, and I thought, no, I'm going to go in there instead.
Yeah. Oh dear. So you hit the bike with your shoulder?
I hit the crossbar.
Yeah.
And the mirror area.
I'm
okay.
And that's with knobblies on. And it's we haven't got knobblies.
Let's face it.
It's too wet and slippery.
When I see that, I thought that is going to be deep. You guys might be alright, you've got a bit more ground clearance than me. I can see Sandy went through okay, you'll be okay.
Yeah, you'll be okay on this side.
I'd go through there rather than up here, guys, because this is just.
Yeah, that's what we're going to get from now on. If it's if it's mud, just don't go on it.
Yeah.
I think maybe we're better off getting along to the White Horse and then getting on the road, I reckon.
Yeah.
Yeah, so Colin had a bit of a mishap there, and he's got these big knobblies on, so just go to show, we ain't going to really cope with the mud in this weather. My bike's going to be plastered by the end of this. Here's the first deep one. Wet feet. Oh. Oh, fuck it. Dick is taking the precautious route. Oh, cowards! Come on through the middle!
Get us going through those!
Well, I did it, yeah, I got us on film.
Oh, you were doing it from back?
Yeah, I got us, yeah.
Okay.
Yeah. We both went through it.
I thought that was a good one.
They didn't go through it.
No.
Cowards.
That's why I'm not going to go on the edge again, because if I slide, you're going to go in it.
Yeah, my feet are wet now.
Yeah, mine are a little bit. They were nice, there was good going through them.
Yeah. Colin, Colin, your side stand. My feet are saturated. Oh, we've got another deep one here. Look at this. There's no... Colin's going to go round. I'll tell you what, that could be a potentially deep one. I'm going to go on the edge through it. Oh, that was a deep one. That was a deep one. That one back there, Dickie, that was the deepest I've been through. It must have been that bloody deep. Oh.
I followed Colin's route, I went down.
I followed Sandy.
It was deep, wasn't it?
I thought one way, the wheel started going to the middle, but no, we're going this way.
Yeah. Colin, the film director.
I reckon if you go up there and get us coming up the hill, you'll get a bit of uphill coming.
Yeah, okay, I'll go ahead.
Where's the lens on there? Because there is rainwater on it.
There.
There, do you want me to wipe it?
Give it a wipe.
I'm looking in my mirror and seeing all this in the background.
Yeah, I'll go ahead a little bit, 100 yards to stop, and I'll film you coming up. That'll do, Colin. Well, I'll go ahead 100 yards. Yeah. Definitely a bit squirrely on the loose stuff. Could do with some better tyres really. Just take it easy and we should be alright. Living the dream, they're on an adventure before dementia. Do you want to sit on the chair?
I'm going to sit on my bike, come on, more the merrier. Don't bend the bloody...
So what's going on here then?
Well, you don't get your bum wet, see? So yeah. You just chuck them on the floor and they make a really nice little settee.
Yeah, that's a good idea. So anyway, if you've got him laying, if you don't want to get a wet backside when you sit down,
yeah, just lie him down.
Just
Well, when Dickie said you want to have a sit on my Himalayan, I thought, yeah, that'd be a good idea. I didn't think it was going to be like this, though.
And while we're here all nice and comfy, we'd like to order four coffees, please.
Oh, yeah, who's going to go and fetch him then?
Yeah, you are.
Oh, anyway, yeah, there you go.
Whoever's the cleanest,
a great seat.
Oh dear. I better pick it up now before we explode in a ball of flame.
Let's see if you can pick. Show us how to pick a bike up, Dickie.
Right.
Well, Dickie is now going to demonstrate how to pick a bike up.
I'm going to do it the proper way.
No, that's how you do it.
That is the beauty of having lightweight bike
book, is it?
You're supposed to put your back into it.
If you had them Africa twins and them big adventure bikes, you wouldn't do that.
There we go. So there they are, there's the magnificent team. We've made it along the ridgeway. Now we're heading off now to Avebury for coffee and cake. Look at that for a view. Isn't that such a beautiful view? Shame it's the end of summer. This is actually the equinox was this weekend just gone. So we're now into autumn. So it's rather a blustery, stormy scene as we ride along the road from Swindon to Avebury. Here we are. You can just make out the ramparts now. This road actually goes straight through the centre of the circle. Magnificent.
This is now coffee and cake time. See, we need to recharge our batteries, just like our bikes need recharge, and we need recharging as well.
We certainly do. And where are we, Colin?
We are at the Avebury Cricket Club Cafe.
Lovely here, isn't it?
Very good venue, can recommend it, especially on a Saturday morning for breakfast.
Yeah, and just behind us is the Avebury Stone Circle. And over here is the cricket room.
I've
just been talking to Dickie. Dickie says, don't say that. Dickie's got a teddy bear.
Well, yeah, but it's when I was a little baby, and I've still got it to this day.
He's still got it, though.
Yeah, and I still sleep with it. No, I don't, not really.
No, he doesn't, really. Right, we're heading back up to Hatpin Hill, Whitehorse now. You can just see it in front of me on the hill, the chalk figure there. Then we're going to pick up the ridgeway, head back home, and then that's basically it. The conditions on the byways were just too slippery, so we couldn't do the route we had planned, unfortunately. So I'm glad to say Colin is a lot better now. He did hurt his ribs, but it looks like he's going to survive to ride again. And so all's well that ends well, I guess, really. So thanks for watching. We'll tie up the video here, I think. And I'll just leave you with the view of the ridgeway as we ride along it, heading back to Rorton, and then on the way home.